I'm not sure what time do you have during either this week or next week. We try to find time to get together to practice the answer for workbook. What's your schedule looks like? Can you find time for that? That was allowed by the contract for sick time. But however, we haven't had time to get correction for the workbook. So we can make up one class if you like. So what kind of schedule do you have? So for the workbook, today we will finish the lesson, but for the workbook we have to find time to get together, give your answer. Or if you have any questions about your final essay, we also can have some time to help you with the grammar about the essay. Okay, let's read the vocabulary. And also read the dialogue. Let's read that. 寒假, 245, 254. Oh, I'm sorry, 266. 266. Last time we already finished this. 266.
No.
This is for 102. This is for 102. I made a note there. So this. How to pronounce this one? This is ban, but there is we said this is for the vocabulary it's just the help with the pronunciation. War, for example, without is van, van, and one plus is war. War.
War.
From one plus war.
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 Great.
Le.
This is a particle. For example, 吃了, means eat, right? 吃了 means I have already eaten. Sometimes le has different usage. The first one is about you finish something, then you use le. For example, write means 写了, write. This is in English means write, right? Or the past tense is wrote, right? If I say 写了, so in English it should be wrote, because finish past. So this is the le, how to use le.
图书馆一起
Okay, so here is again. So, 聊天. For example, without is this 聊. Right? So without repeat after me.
聊天
plus So it's the same thing, an plus right? An plus So listen to me. 聊天 chat. 聊天 Yeah, for example, do you have time? Let's chat. 你有时间吗? 时间 means time. 我们聊天 So, 聊天 For writing, in writing, you can say 聊天 But for speaking, put earlier, 聊天
聊天
means chat. 聊天 Okay. 聊天 literally means the sky, right? 聊天 it means spend time, right?
才回家
Okay. This is Mary at a friend's house. Have you listened to the recording about the narrative?
Yeah.
Oh, great. Mm-hmm. So, what they are talking here at a friend's house? What's the discussion here? How many characters here? So the first line is Wang Peng, right? So Wang Peng, right?
Oh.
This is one. And Liu, right? This is two. Narrative.
I thought we were on 5-5-2. I thought it was this one that we were... Oh, it is. Sorry.
1-3-5. Yeah, before, yeah. So the vocabulary is after the narrative, after the dialogue. 1-3-5, right? Here, right? How many chapters here? Didn't review. So the first line is Wang Peng, Li Yu, and Gao Wenzhong, right? So Wang Peng qu he Li Yu, the first line. Okay, that's.
So,
read after me the first line.
昨天晚上。
Wang Peng and Li Yu go to Gao Wenzhong's home to play. Wang Peng he Li Yu qu Gao Wenzhong jia war.
Wang Peng he Li Yu qu Gao Wenzhong jia war.
Great. 在 Gao Wenzhong jia.
在 Gao Wenzhong jia.
At Gao Wenzhong's home, 他们认识了
他们认识了高文中的姐姐。
Get rid of this side. How to close this side? How to close this side?
You see where it says convert? Yeah, well, no. Right, like on the left, there's a little arrow that points away.
Not the middle.
This?
No. Go back to convert.
To the blue.
You see the blue button? The blue button? Yeah. Okay, now to the left. Left, there's a little arrow pointing the other way.
Yeah. Oh, okay, great. Thank you.
Right there was a plus. The plus thing.
Great. Okay, good. Right now you can see it, right?
Yeah.
Do you need to close the lights?
No, it's good.
Oh, okay.
Very good.
Oh. Say, last night, Wang Peng and Li Yu go to Gao Wenzhong's home to play. At Gao Wenzhong's home, they get known. Gao Wenzhong's, how to pronounce this?
They met.
Have met.
They met.
Yeah. How to pronounce? How to pronounce that?
To pronounce sister?
Uh-huh.
姐姐。
姐姐勾当，姐姐，
姐姐，
姐姐。Yeah. Just like this. In Chinese, if, for example, we say 姐姐, right? This is 姐姐 or sister. So for second word vocabulary, if repeat the first one, in Chinese we use this is just handwriting to instead. Once you see this, you know this is repeat the first one. For example, you can say, you can write, what's this?
Mama,
right? And you also can write in this way. This is just handwriting. This means repeat the first
one.
Yeah, yes. So all these kind of situation, the second character is the same as the first one. This second one always neutral tone. It means zero, right? There's no tone here. No tone, T-O-N-E. So for example, I repeat, mama. So neutral tone, it means it's soft and light, right? For example, 姐姐, you can say, why pronounce the first 姐, a little bit, you can say the sounds are higher, right, than the second one. For example, 姐姐, 爸爸, 妈妈, 妹妹, 哥哥, 弟弟. Can you feel that? Okay, so you don't need a repetition. 姐姐. So second one is soft and, you know, just 姐姐. 姐姐.
姐姐.
Repeat after me. 姐姐.
姐姐.
妹妹.
妹妹.
哥哥.
哥哥.
弟弟.
弟弟.
爸爸.
爸爸.
妈妈.
妈妈.
Okay, great. So, repeat after me.他们认识了高文中的姐姐。
他们认识了高文中的姐姐。
他叫高小英。
他叫高小英。
在学校的图书馆工作。
在学校的图书馆工作。
图书馆工作。
图书馆工作。
他叫高小英。
他叫高小英。
在学校的图书馆工作。
在学校的图书馆工作。
Okay, let's stop here. This is the first part. So it means everyone knows the meaning, right? So 他叫高小英。Her name is Gao Xiaoying. She works at the school's library, right? So everyone knows this, right? Repeat after me. 昨天晚上。
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 王鹏和李友。
王鹏和李友。
去高文中家玩儿。
去高文中家玩儿。
You can say I stop from, I have a pause before the word, right? So when you study Chinese, you try to figure out if it's a long sentence, you have to figure out where you can have pause, right? So for this case, because this is already long, right? A and B. So, and before the word, you can have a pause.So you cannot say in this way. For example, 王鹏和李友去 then pause. 高文中家玩 You have to say 王鹏和李友 pause 去高文中家玩 Right? Okay. 王鹏和李友
王鹏和李友
去高文中家玩
去高文中家玩
玩
玩
玩
玩
在高文中家，
在高文中家，
他们认识了，
他们认识了， 高文中的姐姐。
她叫高小英。
在学校的图书馆工作。
Okay, let's stop here then now to read to each other about this, this short paragraph.
Hey.
How's
it going? Okay. Yeah, go ahead.
昨天晚上玩朋好理由去高文中家玩，在高文中家，他们认识了高文中的姐姐，她叫高小英，在学校的图书馆工作。
Oh, you want me to do the next one?
No, repeat again. So she just invite us to be read the 图书馆工作呢。
Really? We're not supposed to do the whole thing?
Okay.
昨天晚上王鹏和李友去高文中家玩，在高文中家，他们认识了高文中的姐姐，她叫高小英，在最小的图书馆的工作。Well, no, it isn't. You know, I mean, I get everything. The accents, I don't get them and stuff. But yeah, you obviously are way better. But go ahead, do it again.
昨天晚上，王鹏和李友去高文中家玩，在高文中家，他们认识了高文中的姐姐，她叫高小英，在学校的图书馆工作。
You need to put some sound in there, like, 图书馆，图书馆，
图书馆
，Yeah,
图书馆。
You say it correct, but you not have sound in there. So
I know. Yeah, it's the hardest.
That's
the hardest part. Yeah, no, I know. 昨天晚上，王鹏和李友去高文中家玩，在高文中家，他们认识了高文中的姐姐，她叫高娇颖。在最角的图书馆工作。
Yeah, sorry.
Better, huh? Thank you.
Copy down.
Oh, you did everything already. Can you look at it? Wow, that's so good.
No, that's good.
Okay, so
talk to him. Are you going to tell him to stop?
Yeah. What?
He's, you don't hear him? You can't hear him?
What? So, the call?
Yeah.
Okay, I can talk to him.
Thank you. I would appreciate that.
So, any questions about
it? No. I have a lot of things to do, so I make mistakes. For my English class, I still have the essay.
That's okay. Don't worry about it. Everything else is perfect, right?
Yeah. 去高文中家。
You registered your four class, yes?
Yeah, I did on the first day. Yeah. You haven't done it? No. Oh, I'm sorry. Read this again so that I can get it.
Yeah, go ahead. No, you go ahead. 昨天晚上，王鹏和李友去高文中交往。在高文中家，他认识了高文中的姐姐。他教高小英，在学校的图书馆工作。
昨天晚上，王鹏和李友去高文成家，他们认识了高文成的姐姐，他叫高小英，在学校的图书馆工作。
It's okay. It's better.
Yeah, thanks. Do you want to say it again? I know it's boring for you.
You want me to do it again?
Do you mind?
昨天晚上，王鹏和李友去高文中家玩，在高文中家，他们认识了高文中的姐姐，她叫高小英，在学校的图书馆工作。
Okay.
Yoko, your 图书馆.
图书馆.
Yeah.
Okay.
That's when they say,
war. Okay.
Then they say er in behind. You say war.
No.
So hide the er. The this one. Say. You just say war. The you mean the r. They say like war.
Why? Yeah. Why? Good. Okay. Can you say it? Like, do you mind saying it like one word at a time, and then I'll try to copy you?
Okay. 昨天晚上，王鹏和你。
Like one word. Like one word at a time. Like literally one.
昨天，王鹏和李友去 高文中，
高文中，
加
加
瓦
瓦，
在
在
高文中，
高文中
加
加，
他们
他们
认识了
认识了。
高文中
高 sorry 高文中
的
的
姐姐
姐姐，
她将
她她教
高小英
高小英
在
在
学校的
学校的
图书馆
图书馆
工作
工作
yeah, sorry.
Thank you. I know it can't be all that interesting for you, so.
Everything is okay.
So, thank you.
Everything is okay.
Oh,
nice.
Oh, okay.
Thank you. Let's start Okay, let's read another next two sentences. 135, page 135. 他请王鹏喝茶。
他请王鹏喝茶。
王鹏喝了两杯。
王鹏喝了两杯。
So this is one, this is 一杯, right? 杯, 杯 means cup. This is 一杯. You know, Chinese has matter word. So 杯 is a matter word. This is 一杯, then, but 王鹏喝了两杯, right? 两杯, 两杯, 两杯. This is 一杯。王鹏喝了两杯 ，right？ 两杯。
两杯。
他请王鹏喝茶。
他请王鹏喝茶。
王鹏喝了两杯。
王鹏喝了两杯。
She invited 王鹏 for a cup of tea. 王鹏 drink two cups of tea.How do two cups of tea, right? Correct? Two cups of tea. Okay. So, yeah, this is the meaning. 王鹏李友不喝茶。
李友不喝茶。
李友 don't drink tea. 李友不喝茶。
李友不喝茶。
只喝了一杯水。
只喝了一杯水。
Only drink one cup of water.只喝了一杯水。
只喝了一杯水。
Okay, just practice this for a short sentence with your partner.
Okay. Oh, sorry.
I'll read the symbol every moment, okay? 他
他
请
请
王鹏
王鹏
喝
喝
茶
茶，
他请王鹏喝茶，
他请王鹏喝茶，
王鹏喝了两杯 ，sorry， smoke， 王
王
鹏
鹏
喝
喝
了
了
两
两。
杯
杯，
王鹏喝了两杯。
王鹏喝了两杯。
李友，
李友，
不喝茶。
Sorry， 李友不喝茶，
只喝了一杯水。只 say 这
这个
喝
喝
了
了
一
一
杯
杯
水
水
只喝了一杯水
只喝了一杯水
yeah 可以
You want to do the next one? I'll just copy you. Just go ahead.
Okay. 他请王鹏喝茶。
Oh, whoops.
Because she just wanted us to repeat that three sentences.
Okay. 他请王鹏喝茶。
王鹏喝了两杯。
王鹏喝了两杯。
李友不喝茶。
李友不喝茶，
只喝了一杯水。
只喝了一杯水。
Just try three sentences.
他 and then this one I get up caught up on.
请
哦，他请王鹏
来请金 ，You remember?
Yeah.
请，
他请王鹏。喝茶，
喝茶，
喝茶，喝茶。王鹏，喝了两杯。
王鹏喝了。
王鹏喝了两杯。OK。他请王鹏喝茶。
茶，
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 茶。他请王鹏喝茶。王鹏喝了，王鹏喝了两杯。OK， 李友不喝茶。
Just only
one.
That's mean in the sentence. Just only drink a cup of water.
只喝了一。
杯
水
水
水这 This one
只
只喝了一杯水 Can you say the whole thing? The whole sentence, please?The whole sentence, like the whole, yeah.
For the whole day?
No, from 他。
他请王鹏喝茶，王鹏喝了两杯，李友不喝茶，只喝了一杯水。
他请王鹏喝茶，王鹏喝了两杯 ，right？ 王鹏喝了两杯，李友不喝茶，这喝了一杯水。Thanks. 他请王鹏喝茶，王鹏喝了两杯。你又不喝茶，只喝了一杯水，杯水，
一杯水，
一杯水。他请王鹏喝茶，王鹏喝了两杯。你又不喝茶，只喝了一杯水。他请王鹏喝茶，他请王鹏。 touching Wang Hong.
Everything is so good?
Yeah, she's really good. She was really very helpful.
Oh, okay.
She like read the whole thing for me so that I could get it from here.
Okay,
yeah.
Great.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Okay.
Touching Wang Hong.
Touching Wang Hong喝茶，Li Yong不喝茶，只喝了一杯水。
Okay. Another four sentences. So do you think this, when we break down as a short group, it's easy for you to follow?
Yeah.
Okay, great. That's good.
他们一起聊天。看电视。
They get together to chat and watch TV. 他们一起聊天。看电视。For Chinese, this means, for example, something part of. For example, 一起, 我们一起, for example, watch TV, right? 我们一起 chat, for example, chat. Then English, you use 他们, right? So for Chinese, if we do something together, 聊天, then this. Watch TV, this. If we also do other things, reading, we also have another, right? Read, for example, read books, then we will do this again. If we still have other things, for example, listen to music, we will say listen to music, right? You use this not comma, okay?
Wang Peng和李友晚上十二点才回家。
Wang Peng and Li Yu go home until 12 a.m. Or we have another word to say that it means. If we say this word, for example, this is 凌晨, almost just the pronunciation just like 零, right? We say 零, 一, 二, 三, 四, right? 零, 零, 凌晨, 晨 means morning. 凌晨 means earlier morning. You can say 凌晨 1 o'clock, 凌晨 2 o'clock, 凌晨 1点, 凌晨 2点, 凌晨 3点, right? 凌晨 4点, right? But 凌晨 means earlier morning. You can say 凌晨 12点, right? Or you can say 晚上 12点. Okay, but you won't say, I think that 凌晨 12点 just like English, 12 a.m., right? This for a foreigner, for example, at the beginning I said, oh, how to say 12 a.m. In Chinese, we most likely say 晚上. If past 12, for example, 一点, we say 凌晨一点. You know 一点, right? 点 means clock, right?
凌晨 is a.m.
凌晨 means a.m. But 凌晨 only means earlier morning. For example, if 7 a.m., you won't use 凌晨. You will use morning morning, just like, morning. What's the word for afternoon? What's the word of
afternoon?
What's the word for before 12 p.m.?
Morning.
Morning, right?
Yeah.
So yeah, just say morning. 凌晨 means only, for example, very earlier. For example, a.m. to, 5 a.m., right? It means very earlier. Or it's by, maybe even, for example, 凌晨 4 a.m. So it means earlier morning. You won't say 7 a.m. It's not 凌晨. 凌晨 most likely is from 1 to 3, more accurate.
How do you say 7?
早上七点. We said, we have 早上, right? Say, we say 晚上. The first sentence, we say 昨天晚上, right? 昨天晚上. 晚上, we say, the first sentence is 昨天晚上, right? 晚上. If at 7 a.m., we will say 早上七点. For example, 早上七点. 早上七点, 我来学校. For example, right? 我来学校. Or 我去工作. Or 我坐. 车, 我坐车, right? 车, okay. So, 早上, this is how Chinese say. Or another is, for example, if it's 上, we also say this. You know this, right? Let me say, 早上. If 早上, for example, 7 a.m. 八, 7点, or 8点, 7点, 8点, we say 早上, right? For example, if 10点, we won't say 早上, we won't say 早上, because 早上 means early, 早上 means just like 6点, 7点, 8点. But 早上 means the beginning of the before you go to work, right? So for example, 10 a.m. we will say 上午. If after 12 we say 下午. 12 we say 中午. So 中午 is 12点. For example, 我们十二点吃午饭 means 12 we eat lunch 中午. So this is so you know Chinese character is just like a picture. So 上 from here is just like so this means the horizon. You know, so this is 上, so this is 下, below something, right? 中午, 中 means the middle, right? Okay, so,
Ta men yi qi liao tian. 起聊天。
看电视。
看电视。
This is too close, so it will feel. 王鹏和李友。
王鹏和李友。
晚上。
晚上。
十二点。
十二点。
才回家。
才回家。
Okay,
so with your partner, I
need this two
sentences.
Okay,
Tan and Yi Chi.
王鹏，
王鹏
和
李
友，
和李友，
晚上十二点，
十二点
才回家。他们一起聊天。
聊天
回家
他们一
起来 together 一起
他们一起
聊天 You mean like you work together? Say the here.
Oh.
War. Say 聊天
聊天 okay.
You don't want to say the or. You say no, 聊天
聊天
Yeah.
聊天
Yeah.
Is this one? The rest of it? That's it. This here.
Where are you at?
What's the rest of it?
Like, you mean?
No, it's okay.
This、Just、one is
the last one here.
The right? You mean you speak English? You say the S.、Mm-hmm. You will never say S.Like very
slow. Oh, yeah.
They same for the Chinese.
Okay.
So this one how to explain to you. So this one just 聊天
Okay.
They together.
他们一起。
一起。
一起。他们一起。起聊天。
聊天。
聊天。
Yeah.
聊天。
看。
电影。
Yeah.
王鹏
和李友
晚上
十二点才回家 You want me to read again?
Yes, please.
他们
一起
聊天看电影王鹏和李友晚上
十二点
才回家
yeah. 看电视 is watch television, right?
Yes.
Okay, 王鹏和李友晚上十二点才回家 is that midnight? 回家
Go home
十二点
midnight
十二点
Like you guys drink a lot of
coffee 黄鹏和李友望乡下而家，再回家。
But we do have coffee on the in store. Yeah, because
他们一起，他们一起。
I didn't notice. I thought I had pressure with my
brother
the next day.
他们一起，一起，他们一起，聊天，聊天。
At the beginning, I didn't notice.
看电视，看电视，看电视，看，看电视。
Yeah, that's why, to meet with Chinese, it's
他们一起，他们一起，那算了，他们一起，聊天。Yeah, it's okay. He's still being really obnoxious, you know.I mean, he hasn't stopped. You can hear him, right?
Yeah, I didn't hear because why do you pay so much attention to him? That's the worst part.
Because he insists on having me pay attention to him. Because he just will not stop making that noise. He's been doing it for weeks. Yeah, and he's lying. He's been doing it for weeks and weeks. And he's laughing right about it, like right in your face and my face also. I mean, I think I'm trying, but the person
that's supposed to be. He likes laughing.But it's not love for us. He loves for. He just like love.
I'm sorry, that's not true. And when I talked to the head of the language department, he said he would ask you to tell him to stop.
Yeah, I told him.
And he hasn't stopped.
If he made that on purpose, I told him he must stop. But he also told him he is sick, and his neighbor, that guy, also said, I couldn't stop because I'm sick.
And they're not telling the truth. They're lying.
They are?
Yeah, they're bullies. They're being bullies. They're trying to disrupt the class. They're not telling the truth. It's been going on for weeks, and they're enjoying it very much.
Do you feel they are doing that on purpose, or you?
Professor, it's not fair to put her on the spot. I'm the target of this bullying. Right, and I've asked you to do something about it.
How about this? We discuss that if you still have this concern, we still can discuss that during the break, or we still can meet with the professor, the department chair together. So just let's concentrate on study.
I'm recording this. I'm recording the sounds that he's making. I'm in this conversation also, which I have the right to do because it's a classroom, right? But there's no reason that he should be allowed to continue to do this. He's just disrupting the class. He doesn't need to worry about this because he already speaks Chinese, and I don't. But it's very disruptive, and it's been going on for weeks. And you said to me that you would do something about it, and you haven't, which I find very disappointing.
I told you, and the department chair also met him already. So we both did a lot of work on this. What I'm suggesting is right now, we are doing the class, let's just practice the sentence. Ryan, if you have other, still have this concern, we still can meet and discuss it, right?
The chair met him after you and I talked?
Before.
And then I talked to the chair and said he's doing this on purpose. And the chair said he would talk to you and ask you to tell him to stop.
Yes, we did.
Yes, which you haven't done. He's not stopping. Okay, so where were we? Sorry about that. This one I never remember.
Okay.
here. Let's go back here. See, 你有不喝茶, 不喝茶, 不,
不, 不,
不. So, you do, right? Can we come here? 不喝茶, so, 不. It's before he, right? So the sentence structure we said for negative bu plus, right? For example, you can say 我不喝茶 or 我不喝咖啡不喝 or you know, just say 我 我不喜欢 means like 聊天 right? So you know how put book here is the same order as American as English. For example, we said I don't drink tea, right? It's the same. Okay. Okay, let's go to the grammar. Say, go to the grammar. The particle le, the particle the. Dynamic, how to pronounce it?
Dynamic.
So the first usage is the occurrence or completion of an action or event. Or second, the emergency of a situation. This is what kind of situation we use the. For example, when you say finish something, completion of an action, right? For example, I said 我喝了一杯水，喝了一杯茶, right? So finish this. Or occurrence. It means you finish, it also means you finish one action, right? Or the emergency of situation. We will see the example below. The action, event, or situation usually pertains to the past, but sometimes it can refer to the future. For example, this is the example for the future. 我吃了晚饭去看电影. Tomorrow, I will go to watch a movie after dinner. So this is the future action. But as you know, Chinese to indicate future, we put the future phrase, right? Before the subject or after the subject. 明天我吃了晚饭去看电影, or 我明天吃了晚饭去看电影. But here, even though here is the future sentence tomorrow, but if you look at this part as a phrase, For example, 吃了晚饭. So from here, you still can say after dinner. You still can consider the means after an action. Even though the whole sentence is tomorrow or next week, but you still can consider this as a phrase. Here, use the, you still can consider, oh, after each of the dinner. So, this, can you understand this?
Mm-hmm.
We can find another example. So, it means the whole sentence is future, indicate future, but if you pick closer to a phrase, it means after you still finish an action. Okay, let's understand this again. Therefore, le is not a past tense mark. So in this case, make sure you understand this. Most situation, le used as just like finish something. 吃了，喝了，写了, right? But le is not always means finish something. It can also be used in a future sentence. 明天，下星期，后天, okay? So this is the meaning. It means le is not a past tense mark. And the use of le shouldn't be taken as an equivalent to the past tense in English. Right? In this lesson, le indicates the occurrence or completion of an action or event. It's usually used after a verb. For example, 吃了，喝了，写了, this verb, right? After a verb, but sometimes it appears after a verb and the subject of the verb. So, for example, it means in a just narrative sentence or in a sentence, it's trying to negotiation sentence. So, for example, we can look at this example that explain it more. For example, 今天妈妈喝了三杯水. Today, mom drank three glasses or cups of water. Okay, it means you just described what happened, right? The fact is, 妈妈喝了三杯水. For example, we also can say, this situation. For example, I give you this example. 今天早上我喝了一杯咖啡。今天早上我喝了一杯咖啡 or 今天早上我喝了两杯茶 So you can say I put the after the verb 喝了一杯咖啡 or 喝了两杯茶
喝了
Yeah, or 喝了一杯可乐 right? So this is, you just copy this sentence. So for the most time, most situation is you already, it's just like English, have done something. Have done something. For example, if you change this to English, you may say, I have drunk two cups of tea this morning. Right? You consider the as have done something. In this most case. But even though we say in the future, for example, 明天我吃了晚饭去看电影 In this case, in English, we use I will watch a movie after dinner. After tomorrow, after dinner tomorrow. Right? In this case, you may not translate it into I will watch a movie after I have eaten dinner tomorrow. Right?Do you understand? You won't translate it in have eaten a dinner. Have eaten dinner. You will say, tomorrow I will go to see a movie after dinner. Because you haven't done yet. You just describe the situation, right? Tomorrow. So,it means in this situation, it hasn't done yet for tomorrow, you just say after dinner. Right? But most case, if we say today, because, I have already drunk three cup of tea and a piece of bread. This one. Right?It means you finish the action. Okay, let's see the example. For example, 星期一，小高请我喝了一瓶可乐。星期一 ，Monday， 小高 invite me to drink a bottle of 可乐。This is the translation, right? So let's closer to read. 我喝了一瓶可乐。我喝了一瓶可乐。Because in English, you don't have the, you just say, I drink, or I have drink, I have drunk, right? A bottle of 可乐。I have drinkI have eaten a piece of bread, right? So this is 喝了。昨天晚上你去打球了吗？打球 right? 打 is hit, H-I-T, right? 打球 play. In this case, you also can translate it as play.Play, right? 打球了吗？It means ask your past, right? Last night, did you play ball last night? Right? 打球。Okay, so this is an example. Another example is, 我昨天晚上 last night, I...So this is Chinese sentence structure. Two verb get together. 我去，去 means go, 打球 right? 我去 play ball. In English is I play ball. You don't need I go to play ball, right? So the in the end of sentence here also means finish an action.Right? 打球了。Yeah. Okay. 昨天晚上我去打球了。 我去打球了啊。So yeah, this is an example. Let's read this. Note. Let's see another example. Here is, for example, this is Harry Potter. In Chinese, they translate this as 哈利波特. Right? Maybe it's, yeah, so this is, they translate to Chinese according to English pronunciation. 我昨天晚上,我昨天,昨天 yesterday, right? 我昨天看了 watch Harry Potter movie. It was great, right?So here, 看了, right? It means you're finished. You describe something, are you finished? 我昨天 yesterday, I watched Harry Potter movie. It was great. This is 看了.For example, I can say, oh, 我昨天看了电视 or we can say, for example, 我昨天看了Hillary Clinton's speech in TV, right? Or through TV, or on TV, okay.So, it means, yeah, I watched the campaign on TV, right? I finished that, you know, what? This is the, another example. So, to say that an action didn't take place in the past,use 没有 instead of 不什么什么的 It means if you want to say 不有 in this case you use 没有 instead of 不什么什么的 For example 昨天我没有听音乐昨天 IDidn't listen to music. 昨天我没有听音乐 Right? 昨天我没有听音乐 So you won't say 昨天我不听音乐了 You won't say this. You will say 昨天我没有听音乐 For example, if you 不什么什么了 this phrase only say,For example, we go to restaurant, right? I ask you after you're eaten, for example, a plate of rice and vegetable together. I said, do you want to eat more? Then you will answer me, 不吃了，不吃了。It means 不什么什么的，我不吃了。I ask you, Do you still want to drink a cup of tea? You said, 不喝了，不喝了。So that is in this, 不什么什么了，不喝了，不吃了。But if in this case, 昨天我没有听音乐。If you want to say something, I didn't do something yesterday, you use 没有。Right? 不什么什么了 it's most likely present situation. 我不吃了 it's enough. 我不喝了 Right? 我不写了 Right? Or 我不说了。For example, let's have a break. 我不说了 I mean, I stopped speaking, right? So in this case, we use 不什么什么的 But if you want to say the, say, for example, 昨天我没有听音乐 You won't say 我不有听音乐 This is a, another example.This is a wrong. 昨天我，我昨天我，you can say this situation. 昨天我不听音乐了。This is wrong. You can say 昨天我没有听音乐。This is example. You can say 不什么什么了。You will say 没有什么什么，没有什么什么了。Because, for example, if I say 我不听音乐了。Most likely, right now, 我不听音乐了。Okay, not the past. Here is another example. 你吃饭了吗？你吃饭了吗？In English means have you eaten? Right? 你吃饭了吗？你吃饭了没有？你吃饭了没有 It's the same, the meaning is the same, different way to ask the same question. You can say, for example, we have earlier class, right? I will ask, 今天早上你吃饭了你吃饭了吗 Right? I can ask you, 今天早上你吃饭了吗 I ask him, right? For example, 今天早上你吃饭了吗 Have you eaten this morning? Yes, right. Or I can ask another, for example, I ask you,你吃饭了？今天早上你吃饭了没有？没有，没有吃。Okay, so it's the same meaning. Just ask, have you eaten? But in Chinese, you have different way to say. So this is two ways. 你吃饭了吗？ This is one way. Or 你吃饭了没有？ So you know this situation. Have you eaten?Or not, right? So this is the situation. So the answer is 我没吃 or 我吃了 For example, he said 我吃了 right? You answer me, if I said 你吃饭了吗 Then 我吃了 I finished, I haven't eaten, right? So I asked this girl, 你吃饭了没有 She said, 我没吃今天早上你吃饭了吗？我没吃。Right. So, or I may ask you, 你喝了几杯水 ？This morning, Tom, 你喝了几杯水 ？How many cup of water you drink? For example, 你喝了几杯水 ？If I ask you right now, 你喝了几杯水？You oh, I drink three or two cup of water, two cups of water, right? 你喝了几杯水 Have you how many cups of water? You have drunk, right? So this is because you know this is a difficult situation because.Chinese only have the past tense. For example, the translation they put here is did. Because Chinese doesn't have done this structure. So that's why for Chinese, it's difficult for them to understand or they mix up about have eaten or ate. For example, I ate lunch.I haven't eaten lunch, something. So they couldn't tell the nuance. That's why when you put the Chinese translate to English, so it often have these questions. Use did or use have done structure. So just remember, le after a verb means you finish something. In most cases, for example, I say 我喝了一杯水. So in this case, let's translate to drank one cup of it means past. But to English speaker, it's better for you to think about have drunk. I think the have done structure for you to understand this better than past tense. So this is you may we have a break, you may think about this, and we will when you come back then read the note later. Maybe 10 minutes to read on. Excuse me.
What is she saying? I thought it was due the week after.
But she's around. Let me ask her about it. That's what it says on Moodle, and what she said.
You put the word in the end of the sentence. Subject in the end of the sentence. The first sentence. Oh, I understand. With which character first? So in Chinese, we want to find the first. For example, 我和你. In English, you will say 你和我.
Right.
So, yes, you just say 我和你, or 我和他们. You want to say 他们. In general, we always think of 我 first. 我和你, 你和我, both are okay, but we want to mention yourself first. Yeah.
Thank you.
It's all right. Yeah, you have.
Okay. Yeah, see the answer. No one in there.
About the love. So, as we said last class, love doesn't equivalent to a past tense. So, but some situation, if it's, for example, say something about the past, or 我吃了,喝了, or 吃了, 我吃了一片 or a piece of bread, or 我喝了一杯茶, in that case, that is a past. But another situation is, for example, new situation. 我现在是大学生了. You describe a situation, right? 我现在是大学生了。去年, for example, last year I was in high school, but 我现在是大学生了。Right now, I'm a college student.
This is a new situation. You can use le. 我现在是大学生了。In this case, le after the noun. 大学生了。Another thing, another situation. All the new situation. Another example is 王鹏和李友现在是好朋友了。王鹏和李友现在是好朋友了。Right? It means in the past, they just know each other, knew each other. But right now, they become close friend or very good friend. Right? So this is a new situation. Another situation is just describe a situation. 我不喜欢看美国电影了。I don't like to watch American movie anymore. Here, when you say 我不喜欢看美国电影了 I 不喜欢 I don't likeTo watch 美国电影 It means in the past It's implied that in the past I watched American movies Right? Right now 我不喜欢看美国电影 I don't like to watch 美国电影 anymore Okay, this is a new situation We use the So, can you think about one example? Can you describe a new situation? Use the. For example, I give you a. 我现在是美国人了。Example, right? 我现在是美国人了。It means I'm an immigrant right now, right? So 我现在是美国人了。Just an example, right? For example, another example. 我现在说中文，我现在说中文了，哦，我现在学中文了。I mean, in the past, you didn't learn Chinese, right? 我现在学中文了，我现在。说中文了。For example, another example. So in this situation, you use 现在 It means new situation, right?我现在喜欢吃 hamburger 了 hamburger sandwich, right? In the past, I don't like to eat sandwich and hamburger. But right now, 我喜欢吃sandwich, right? 我现在喜欢喝咖啡了。In the past, I only like to drink tea. Right? Can you give me an example?
Well.我不喜欢喝茶了。 我不喜欢喝茶了。
OK, yes, that's a good example. 我不喜欢喝茶了。We'll describe a new situation, right? So these two is, this is just narrative, right? This is you don't like to.
So what I was trying to say was I didn't used to like tea. Did I say it right, or did I say I don't like tea now? What did I say? I said 我不喜欢喝茶了, and I was trying to say I didn't used to like tea. But what did I say?
What's you really want to say? What's
I didn't used to like tea.
I
did not used to. I did not used to like it, but now I like it.
But
yeah.
The situation is, 我不喜欢喝茶了. It means in the past you liked tea. In the past,
oh, okay.
You liked tea.
It means
but
I don't.
Right now,
I don't anymore.
Yeah, I won't want to drink tea anymore.
Okay.
So if you want to say that sentence, it means you wasn't used to. You have to use another sentence structure to describe.
Okay. All right.
So yeah.
Thank you.
Yeah. Is there any examples? Me.
我现在喜欢打球了。
Yeah. In this case means in the past, I don't like to play ball.Because right now, 我喜欢打球。Okay, so this is a new situation. Another is completed action. Normally goes after verb, but sometimes after object. Let's say the example. Although the can be used in both past and the future to indicate completion of an action, the following structures are for past events only. So it means here, only give you an example for the past events. For example, when.The goes after verb. For example, 我 subject 我 verb 喝了 number 3 or 2 measure word 杯 right 一杯茶 right so 一杯水 object for example in this case 我 subjectVerb, 喝了 right? Number, 三杯 measure word, 水 object, right? So, 我今天喝了三杯水 Or, this translation is today, I have already drunk 3 cups of water. This, right? But for this, 我去中国的时候 when I went to China, I knew a lot of Chinese friends, 中国朋友 right? 我认识了很多中国朋友很多 many 中国 China Chinese friends right so this is 认识了 I have known 我去中国的时候 this is when I went to China I knew a lot of Chinese friends knew a lot of Chinese friends right So this is the new this structure. So every time after the class, I upload the sentence structure or the grammar on Moodle. Have you
Have you read? Reviewed? So what I'm saying is, you may, for the grammar, you may need to review after the class. We cannot only rely on the class, right? We have to do review. Okay. This is one, another one is subject, past verb, the past proper noun. Okay. Followed by a clause to complete the entry sentence. For example, 王鹏去高文中家的时候, when 王鹏 went to 高文中's home, 认识了高小英, 他很喜欢他。 When Wang Peng visited Gao Wen Zhong's home, he knew Gao Xiaoying. He likes her very much. Here, 认识了. For example, when you came to the class first time, we knew each other, right? In Chinese is 你来教室 classroom, right? 你来教室的时候, 时候 means the time, at the blah blah blah, the time, right? 我认识了你们，你们也认识了我 ，right？ 我认识了你们，你们也认识了我 ，right？ What's this？
你
This is men, right? 你们 men is a plural. Why do you put a plural after the pronoun? For example, 我们 This is 我, right? 们 make 我 become plural. 我们 你们, 我认识了你们, all of you. So, another example is 我今年三月去中国的时候, I went to China in March, 三月 March, 今年, this year. 去 go 中国的时候 去了北京 visited 北京 and 南京 you know 京 means capital 北 means north 南 means south so 北京 北京 everyone know 北京 right so 北京 is a capital for a few Chinese dynasties. Nanjing also a capital for a few dynasties. Chinese, you know, Chinese dynasty has long, Chinese has long history with many dynasties, right? So this is Nanjing, this is Beijing. Both are very important. So for, you know, Taiwan, right? Before the Taiwanese moved to Taiwan from Nanjing. Okay. So, let's see this. Visited Beijing and Nanjing. Visited Beijing and visited Nanjing. 去了. Right. This is example. We can do some. That's a few.
finish this and we do some exercises. So this is another example about le goes after object. For example, 你, for example, 他去跳舞了。他去跳舞了。他去跳舞了。The context is, your old brother at home, 你哥哥在不在家? 在不在? This is, we learned a, not a, the structure, right? 在不在? Means a, not a. Ask a question. For example, 在不在? Or, 是不是? 是不是? For example, I ask you, 你是不是一名学生? 你是不是一名学生? Right? Or someone ask you, 你是不是一位老师? I said, yes, I am. Right? 是不是? Remember this sentence, this structure, A, not A. It, in general, it asks something you are not sure. For example, 你哥哥在不在家? Is your old brother at home or not? 不在, no. He isn't at home. He went to dance. In this case, le goes after the object. So, 他去, for example, 他, subject, 去, so 他去, object, right? Then, object, then plus le. This is structure, right? 他去跳舞了, or I guess 她, the girl who just go out, right? 她去, for example, 她去, for example, let me see, 她去休息了。休息 means have a rest, just make a joke on her. So 她去休息了, because she go out, right? So 她去, 她去 have a rest. Le. Yeah. Or 他去 pick up a phone. Right? So this is 他去. 去 is verb, right? 他, 他, the girl is this, right? 他去 打电话. 打电话 means pick up a phone, right? 打电话. Le. So this is object le. So we will practice after. Yeah. So another is li yo wei she. So another one is li yo wei she me bu he wo men yi qi liao tian. Ta hui jia le. For example, we will ask you, oh, this teacher why not join us to discuss the movie together? Why? Then you answer me, 他回家了。他回家了。他回家了。 This also 他 subject 回 verb plus object plus object 了 le go after the object. 他回家了. I give your example. This sentence. Give you another example. For example, 我我 In this case, 我吃了 or you know 吃 right? Eat. Yeah, 我吃 or I think 我吃饭了。饭 means food. Meal. M-E-A-L. So, 我吃饭了。我吃饭了。Or, this is the same. 我吃了。You can say 我吃了。Or, plus the object. 饭了。Okay. Another example. It's a little bit more verb one and verb two. For example, one action takes after another. For example, 我们吃了。吃了晚饭 object 去看电影 this is 吃 verb 1 了晚饭去 plus 去 verb 2 看电影 right this is an example similar with the textbook, or we can say this sentence, 我想下了课去图书馆看书 I want 下了课 For example, 下了课 means after the class, right? For example, 下了课 please come here to sign up. For example, right? 下了课下了课 and it means after the class. So this is some extra sentences. So negation. Let's do some exercises to practice one for him textbook. One for him.
Bless him.
One for him.I read the example. 小高昨天喝了四杯咖啡。Let's say here. So here, 小高昨天喝了四杯咖啡。Here is a number, right? 四杯。Okay, I will do the first one, then you will pair off to the do next. For example, 我昨天看了一场电影。So the mirror word is 场。Well, you cannot say 一个电影, you will say 一场电影。So, 一场 means, because 场 means, for example, 场 means a big space, 一场电影。So, because this is, for example, one way say, 场 it means a very big space, 一场电影。Because when you say movie, the movie theater is so big, right?So we say 一场电影 We won't say 一个电影、我昨天看了一场电影 Right? So、can you pair off do the 2, 3, 4 Use the Go together
So好 hobbies. Is that the last chapter?
Tell. Dance.
I know. I know you know it. So let's see. Yeah. Jiawu. Jiawu. Okay.
Jiawu.
Jiao Gao Suo Jiang, Jiao Wu Le, what's three?
San.
San. San Ge?
San Chi. Gui Tan.
Che is three times. Che is three times.
Yeah, this one.
Times. It's times. Oh. Are you sure it's not? Che. Oh. I thought it was. Oh, okay.
You can check it.
I thought it was. I thought maybe like. Okay.
So there are three.
Just cha.
For example, if you chant, you can say 昨天唱了, but you have to say, for example, 一首歌. The main word is 首. 十欧首. The pronunciation is just like this. This also 首叹, right? 一首. You cannot say 一个歌. You say the matter word here is 一首, matter word is 首,一首歌. You can say 跳了三个舞, you can say that. This is, you know.
You can use in 歌.
What's the matter word for this one?
瓶,一瓶可乐.
四瓶可乐，瓶或，yeah，you can say瓶，or，yeah，it's not a杯，right？一瓶，yeah，一瓶，一瓶， for example， 一瓶水，it means the bottle，yeah，瓶。
一瓶，汤，香膏，苏浆，唱歌，唱歌三，唱歌三。 唱歌，唱，小狗，苏浆，喝了，四瓶，whatever this one, Coca-Cola.
四瓶, it seems the, this.
Mm-hmm.
This.
Oh, yeah.
But that is 可乐, right?
So, 小狗，苏浆。
四杯可乐. Oh, this is a bay, but this is not a bay.
四瓶可乐, right?
四瓶可乐. But this is not correct. This is a bay.
This is for this one, right?
Oh, you read this, okay. Yeah.
No, I didn't read this. I just understood it from.
See, this is a ping. This is a bay, right?
So this one I was curious about. There's these two I was curious about because. Suo Gao, Suo Jiang, but then it's like, does he?
You can say 我, right?
我,
or 他,
okay.
or 我, yeah, 小高可以, yeah.
我, Suo Jiang,
跳了三个舞蹈. We also can say another major word, but here, 歌 is okay.
I wondered if it was for three songs or just three times. He went dancing three times. you went dancing for three songs. I mean, these two are kind of difficult because it's not, it's like,
yeah.
It's kind of more,
yeah.
You know?
I understand your meaning, but the question is, we just, you can say three times, but we just try to use this, use this picture to practice the sentence structure. Yes, they didn't give, we can think in different way, but here we just try to use the structure they gave us.
Yeah, I
but
know.
But it doesn't matter, you know, three times, or we just try to say, oh, 三个舞蹈, 两首歌, for example, 四瓶水, right?
Okay.
We just try to use the mirror word.
So this would be, 唱了三个
两首歌 you have to use the 手 right here 手 this is the 唱
Watch a movie at your home. It's not a movie theater. You will say 一部电影. You won't say 一场电影 because 场 has to very big, just like a theater. So 一部电影, right? So if you watch 电影 in your home, at your home, you say 一部电影. That's good. That's good. So if you watch at the theater, you will see 一场电影. Right? Okay. So let's also the G also about practice. The G is also about the find out what your partner did last night. You ask, for example, the first one, you ask your partner, 你昨天晚上去朋友家玩了吗? It means last night, you went to your friend's home to play. Right? For example, the first one, last night, you went to your friend's home to play. For example, if I ask you this question, you will say, yes, 我昨天晚上去朋友家玩了。So your answer is just this, right? You don't need ma plus question, that is a question, right? You just say, yes, 我昨天晚上去朋友家玩了。Oh, no, 我没有。The negation is 没有, right? 我昨天晚上没有去。没有 put before the verb. 没有去朋友家玩。I ask, do you understand how to do that? I ask somebody to...For example, I give you a few minutes to think about this one. 你昨天晚上去哪儿了? No, for example, I ask you. Last night,
where did you
go?昨天晚上去哪儿了？我去看电影了。Right? 你昨天晚上去哪儿了？我昨天晚上去看电影了。
You already seen the movie? Did you? It's a movie. You're asking if he. It's a movie, right?Isn't it a movie?
电影.
Did you already see it?
电影 is a movie.
Did you see it? Are you asking if he already saw it? Is that what you're asking?
No, you can answer because this is an open question.
Oh.
For example, it's according to your personal situation. For example, Tom, 昨天晚上你去哪儿了? Sleep. 哪儿也没去。
Oh, we had that, but
I didn't go anywhere. I'm at home, right? So, 我昨天晚上没有去I just 就没有去外面outside, right? I just stay at home to sleep, right? 我昨天晚上so it's just according to your personal situation. For example, 你昨天晚上去哪儿了? Oh, okay. Hold on. 你昨天晚上去哪儿了?
我昨天晚上去图书馆了。
Correct. 我昨天晚上去图书馆了。
图书馆了。
Yeah, 去图书馆了。It means I did something. Yeah, I. Okay. Your question.
How do you say, I went to work last night?
我去工作了。我去工作
了。
工作。工作 means work, right? 我去我去工作了。我去工作了。工作 right? 工作。我去工作了。工作 if it's a noun, it means a job. It can be verb. 我去工作了。我去工作了。Yeah. No. This is a book. This is a book. No problem. Yeah. So. Yeah. Practice with your partner about 你昨天晚上去哪儿哦？你喝什么了？你喝什么了？
Did you already have? What did you already have to drink?
Yeah.
What did you have to drink? What did you have?
Most likely ask your what did you do before? Ask past.
But okay.
你喝什么了?
What did you drink? Right? What did you
yes,
drink? What
yes,
did you drink?
Yes.
Yeah, yeah. Okay. All right. 我喝咖啡啦?
Yes.
了
yeah,
我喝咖啡了、uh-huh. 我喝一杯水了、
uh-huh.
我喝两瓶 cola
可乐 yeah,
yeah. OK
yeah,
yeah.
可乐了 yeah, yes so this is the And another grammar is 才 才 means not until. For example, the adverb 才 indicates the adverb 才 indicates that the occurrence of an action or situation is later than the speaker may have expected. The lateness is perceived by the speaker and is not necessarily objective as seen in 2 and 3.才 never takes the particle whether or not it pertains to an action or situation in the past. So 才 means not until. So this may be a little bit not easy to understand, but let's see the example. It will be easy to understand. For example, 我请他六点吃晚饭 I invite him to lunch at 6 p.m. 他六点半才来 But he didn't come until 6:30. Do you understand?So it means not until. He didn't come until 6:30. This is 才 not until. The 才 means not until. Another example is 小高常常晚上12点才回家。小高 often come home 12点。小高 often doesn't come home until 12点 not until right uh-huh.
Can I just ask some questions? So it's so 常常 means often, 晚上 means evening, right? 12 is 12?
Yes.
Dian, what is Dian?Clock.
For example, in Chinese, if you say, for example, 现在是十一点 it means right now is 11 o'clock.
Yeah.
You have to use 点
Okay.
You, for example, if I ask you, what time is it? You can say 12, right? But in English, in Chinese, the simple situation, you can say 十二, 十一, 十 Because we already ask 几点了几点了 You know, we ask, when we say 几点 you know that ask you are about time. For example, I don't have watch. Yeah, I said, hi, can you let me know 几点了 My watch stopped. 几点了
Then you know I'm asking you about time. Then you say 12点 or 12, right? But if I didn't, it's clear, it's easy for Chinese to say 点 means o'clock. Clock.
Okay.
Yeah. 点 literally means this, dot. This is, right? 点. 点, right? But another meaning is clock. Okay, so another, 她晚上很晚才睡觉. She goes to sleep very late, right? 她晚上很晚才睡觉. This is not until, but it means 才 means very late. 才 very late. So this is this situation. For example, 2 or 3. The lateness is perceived by the speaker and is not necessary. Objective as seen in 2 and 3. So 3, 他晚上很晚才睡觉. For example, for example, 我说了很多 many, right? I explain to you many times. Eventually, you understand the grammar. In this case, Chinese is 我说了 aloud, 你才 understand.
I explain to you a lot, and then you until you understand. I explain it to you a lot until you understand. Is that what you're saying?
Yes.
Yeah.
It's not exactly, but just this. It means I want you to use 才. 才 means the laziness. Mm-hmm. For example, her Chinese is better than you.
Way better.
For example, I explain her 2 sentences. She understand, right? For example, I will say, oh, I explained to her two sentences. She understand. But I explained to you 10 sentences. 你才 understand.
Uh-huh.
So yeah. It means the lateness,
uh-huh.
Right? So, for example, the class started already 1 hour. 你才来. Okay. 才 come. Right? Okay, so this is lateness, right? This is, oh, or I ask you to do the homework. In the end of the semester, 你才 do the homework, for example. It means, so 才 use 2 situations. One is not until. You didn't come until the class start after 1 hour, right? This is not until the first situation, right? This situation is in the end of this semester, 你才 submit your recording. Also, it means it takes time. The first situation, it takes you for time to do something. The second situation, it means laziness. So this is this situation. Let me. So go to the 140. We just use 2 minutes to do 1 exercise. Here. See, this is an example. 我7点喝咖啡，他8点才喝。I drink coffee at 7,
But she drink coffee at 8. 才, put 才 before the verb. Right? For example, I do the I do this first, or I do 5. See, we say I sleep, or 他睡觉，他九点半睡觉. For example, I will say, oh, 他九点半睡觉，我十二点才睡觉. Right? This is, for example, 他看电视, or 他看电脑, right? Or 他看电影, for example, 他看电影. Or we can use this example. We planned to watch movie at 8, but 他 came to meet with me, he didn't come until 8:30. In English, in Chinese, it's 我们八点看电影，他八点半才来. So, understand? Okay, I will, next time, we will do, we still have 1 week to do the workbook and the final, and 2 weeks. I made a mistake, I count, so May 13, count at 8 we will start presentation, yeah, and I don't have to hand on, hand in the paper, the IC.
Yeah, no.
So we still have 1 week to have the time to do some workbook and midterm
reflection. Okay.